Welcome to another video on my channel. I'm Trisha and this is Bowie, my Brazilian rainbow boa, and my goal is to have her not go in the plant over here. And for all of the people that have been commenting and freaking out at me over this plant, it has been watered. It's perking up. I promise I'm not abusing my plants. People are getting very offended over this pothos that was very sad for like the past week, but it has been watered. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about reps with bad reps, meaning reptiles with bad reputations. And this is a topic that's very common, basically just for reptiles in general, because a lot of people just typically don't like reptiles and they think that they all have a bad reputation. There are some exceptions, like people finding geckos to not have bad reputations because people think that geckos are cute. So anything that people think is cute can't have a bad reputation. It's the same thing for turtles. People love turtles and tortoises, so they don't think they're bad. But if you're a snake or a large lizard, people are gonna think you have a bad reputation most of the time. And that's something that I want to change because these animals are so misunderstood and it's so easy for people to make this type of assessment about them and think that they're just bad and they're out to get you because they literally just don't have any experience with these animals or understand them whatsoever. Just as a little comparison, people are very familiar with keeping dogs and cats as pets. Reptiles aren't kept as commonly, but for people that are keeping a dog or a cat, they get scratched and bitten all of the time, way more than you would actually get bitten by reptiles. But they think that it's okay because they have all of these positive experiences with those animals as well, and they can see how great they are. And it's the same exact thing with reptile keeping as well. Because as we're keeping these animals, we're having so many positive experiences with them, and we get to see all of the great things about them, rather than just focusing on all of the bad. So if people literally just focused on dogs and thought, oh my god, they attack people, they've killed people, they're terrible. But people realize that that's not how it is, and that's not how those animals are as a whole, and it's the same thing with reptiles. That's just not how these animals work at all. So in today's video, I'm gonna focus on a select few of the reptiles that are just known to have terrible reputations, whether it's in captivity or the wild, and we're gonna discuss it, and we're gonna discuss how our vocabulary can really have a great impression on people when it comes to reptiles, and how maybe we should change the way that we describe them. Because by doing this, we'll be able to eliminate a lot of those fear factors within people, and people will start seeing them a little bit differently, hopefully. So the very first reptile that I'm going to jump into today are snapping turtles. So people generally love turtles and tortoises because they are so adorable, they aren't gonna harm anyone, but there are snapping turtles, and they have that name for a reason. They are known to bite. They can literally chop your finger off. They have so much force, and they're definitely an intimidating animal. So people think that they are just out to get you, and they're terrible, and they're mean. Words that you should not be using to describe reptiles whatsoever. A lot of the times, people will say that you should describe reptiles as being defensive rather than aggressive, because that's exactly what it is. Reptiles in general will never go out of their way to attack a person for no reason. The only reason that they're ever going to bite anyone is to protect themselves, which is just purely defense. And it's the same exact thing for snapping turtles as well. So if you actually look at a snapping turtle's body, unlike other turtles who have a very large shell that covers most of their body, they're able to tuck their legs and their head into their shell. Snapping turtles don't have this ability. Their heads stick out very far from their shell. It cannot go and tuck inside of the shell whatsoever, along with their legs and their tail. So because of this, they don't have as much protection, so they need to be a little bit more defensive if need be. So they have a lot of like meaty areas. They're very large turtles and they have very like chunky legs and a tail and everything, and they need to be able to defend themselves. So obviously the only thing that they can do is bite or snap. And that's why they're called snapping turtles, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that whatsoever. It's just their defense. It doesn't mean that they're terrible and they're out to get you. They don't want to hurt you whatsoever. They just want you to leave them alone. That's pretty much it. And that's how it goes for all reptiles in general. So snapping turtles have a very bad reputation. Honestly, just leave them alone. If you find one in the wild, just don't stick your finger in front of its face because it doesn't know what you're doing and it's defending itself, just like any other type of reptile. Another reptile that I want to talk about today are tokay geckos. So Tokay geckos are very commonly kept in captivity. They're sold for so cheap. You may see them at like Petco or PetSmart. They're just so common and so cheap. And people are not aware of their demeanor. So these geckos are always known as being mean and aggressive. The thing is, these animals are actually just very highly intelligent. And they're so intelligent that they literally recognize their owners. They understand exactly your intentions. If they don't understand your intentions or feel safe with you, they're going to bite. And that's what people are so afraid of, because they do have a very strong bite, similar to like pit bulls. They just have like a really big, strong head. And when they snap down, they mean business. And that's obviously not something that everyone is prepared for when it comes to keeping a reptile. People buy them all the time because they're cheap and they're pretty. They bring them home and they realize, oh my God, what did I get myself into? So it's just one of those situations. And because of that, people think they have a bad reputation. But honestly, they're just really, really smart geckos. And if you put the time and effort in and work with them, they can tame down over time. But you really need to be willing to put the work in. And if you're not, then it's just not the pet for you. And that doesn't mean anything against Tokay geckos. That's just a matter of you should do your research and pick an animal that's best fit for you and your needs. And an example that I've noticed with Tokay geckos is, because I actually owned one for a little bit, my friend told me that they had a tame Tokay and they really wanted to give it to me. And I expressed many times that I wasn't interested because I knew how they were and I wasn't willing to deal with it. Because you guys know me, I don't really like fast moving geckos. I don't like getting bitten. Like, I enjoy my reptiles because I find that they're relaxing. So I love my boas because they're nice and slow and soothing. So a Tokay gecko just did not seem like a good fit for me. But my friend was like, no, like, I promise you, this gecko is so not defensive whatsoever. It's so calm. It's so chill. So I went over and I held the gecko, and it was very similar to like holding a crested gecko. It was just so relaxed, so amazing. But the thing is, the second I brought it home and I put it in a new environment, I had to start from square one, and the gecko did not trust me whatsoever. It was used to its old owner and how things were done, and it recognized him, and it had no idea who I was. And I had to start over by building trust. And it was just something, again, that I wasn't interested in, and I was hoping that the gecko would remain tame when I received it, but it did not whatsoever. So I actually gave it to my friend Michelle, and she has Dahlia now. And she's had her for like over a year now, and she's improved a lot, but she's working on building the trust and the bond with her gecko. And it just takes a lot of time and work, but for the people that do it, it's very rewarding. They're just very intelligent and amazing animals that do require a lot of work and time and patience. So if that's something that you're willing to do, they make absolutely amazing pets. So people should definitely stop hating on Tokay geckos. Like, yes, they aren't for everyone, but that doesn't make them a bad animal whatsoever. So the next animal that I want to talk about are Burmese pythons, and I'm going to slide iguanas into this category as well, because both of these animals are problematic, and it is basically just because of humans. It has nothing to do with these animals. They haven't done anything wrong. It's the people that took these animals in and were irresponsible pet owners and released these animals into the wild in Florida that made them become an invasive species. So that is exactly why these animals have such terrible reputations, especially in Florida. So basically what happened was, at the start of reptile keeping, reptiles were just becoming pets. People thought they were so cool. People didn't know anything about these animals or how to care for them or how big they were going to be and how much responsibility they would be. So they get this little tiny baby iguana, little baby Burmese python, and of course they're going to grow. And they grew. And people realized that they were in over their head. They couldn't feed these animals. They didn't have the space for them. It was just way too much. So they released it into the wild in Florida. And these animals just thrived. They did so well that they are now an invasive species, and they're killing a lot of the common animals in the area, even the protected animals. And it just totally throws off the whole ecosystem. And it's just so, so bad. So irresponsible of those people. And now these animals have horrible reputations for for human error. So it's just very unfortunate, and they're very misunderstood, and people need to stop blaming the animals for something that people did, because it's totally the people's fault that released them in the first place. And that's why we as reptile keepers need to be very responsible about how we keep our animals as well and learn from those mistakes. So the next group of animals that I want to talk about is not anything specific, but basically all venomous snakes, because people are terrified of snakes all the time, especially the venomous snakes. And people don't understand, and they think that these animals kill people and they're just like malicious and they're out to get you. And again, that is not how these animals work whatsoever. They literally want to hide away. They don't want anything to do with humans. They're scared of us. And that's why people get bitten too, because they're literally just scared. We're a huge predator and they're protecting themselves. That's why they bite. And that's why people get injured and envenomated and could possibly lose their life, because those animals are so powerful and the venom is so strong. But that's just something we need to be aware of and respectful of, and just leave these animals alone in the wild. Don't try and go after one and kill it thinking it's going to come after you, because it's absolutely not going to come after you. It just wants to be left alone. So it's just a huge misunderstanding with all of the venomous snakes. So I just wanted to bring it up in this video and talk about how these animals are not out to get you at all. They literally want nothing to do with you, and that's how it is with all reptiles in general, even the ones without venom. Just like Bowie here, who's literally just trying to get away from me this entire video. Another animal that's highly misunderstood and has a bad reputation is the anaconda. A huge influence on this has to be the anaconda movies. They terrified me as a child, and I was not always comfortable with snakes. And a huge part of it was literally because of those movies. I saw those movies when I was a little kid. They terrified me. I thought all snakes literally just wanted to eat you and kill you. And it's just a huge misconception. That's not how snakes are at all. That's just people trying to make money off of movies and spreading false information. So absolutely, anacondas should be respected. They have the potential to get very large. They can possibly consume human prey, but for the most part, that's not something they're going to be seeking out and looking for. They eat other things, and people just need to be more respectful of those animals and not see them as just dangerous monsters, because they really aren't. I just saw a video on Facebook a couple of weeks ago where a cameraman literally got face to face with an anaconda. Wasn't defensive whatsoever. It literally was just curious about the camera, and it was just sniffing the camera, just like all of the snakes actually do. Bowie does it all the time too. It just goes to show that these animals are not monsters. They're just curious. They want to know what's going on. They do not want to just come and kill you all the time. That's not how it works. So yeah, I hope that this video helped to open someone's eyes. Maybe you know someone that just does not understand maybe one of these reptiles in particular, and they think that they're just really bad and evil and trying to kill you. Or maybe it's just people that just don't like reptiles in general, and they're just viewing them from a place of just unawareness. So maybe this can help open some eyes, because honestly, these animals do have so many amazing qualities. I get bitten by my dog on like a daily basis. He like plays with me and bites all the time. I've never been bitten by any of my snakes ever, and I've been keeping them for like 4 years now. So it's just how it works. Like, people just need to start building more positive interactions, relationships, experiences with reptiles to learn that they are not all evil and out to get you. They absolutely should be respected. They can do damage, but so can dogs or cats or any other animal that you could possibly think of. So it's just a matter of just showing more respect and appreciation for these animals, even though we may not understand them. And honestly, by talking about them more and getting other people to understand them, it will get rid of that fear, and they will have more appreciation, I think, for reptiles in the end. So that's why I'm here making these videos, because I love these animals so much, and I want other people to understand the great qualities about them as well. So please go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know of any other reptile that you want to talk about that you think has a bad reputation. I would love to read your guys' comments, so let's start a conversation. And thank you guys so much for watching my video, and I will see you guys in the next video.